should be going live now. Gonna be doing a expansion draft as the 32nd team. It'll be interesting. I already have an expansion team set up, which is the Birmingham Bulls. They're a SPHL team, which is the fourth tier of pro hockey, right behind the ECHL. So we're gonna do that. Let me just do something real quick. I'm just sharing the stream real quick. Give me just a second. Alright, there we go. So yeah, like I said, we're going to do the Birmingham Bulls. Just a generic logo in the game. There we go. Looks like our AHL team is the Burnaby Aces, I guess. You know, is what it is. Yeah, can we get a better AHL team than that? Come on. Well, that's fine. I just want to... Yeah, let's just put the logo on the front of the jersey. So we're just going to add our main logo for the alternate jersey. We'll, you know, obviously add the alternate logo. This is an interesting jersey. I'll add that. But that was just sending a message. And we'll get these alternate jerseys going real quick. We'll be set. Is for the alternate? Yeah, we want that one. That's right. There we go. Alright, so now I should be able to look at all the jerseys. That looks nice, yeah. That looks nice. Yeah, it's nice. Alright, so we have that figured out. Just save that. That's the only change I wanted to make to that. We'll continue. We're going to play in the Central Division. You know, that way each division has 8 teams. Just makes sense. And, you know, the big part is going to be the expansion draft. I don't really feel like doing with the owner stuff. That's just annoying. Budget, revenue. Waste of my time is really what it is. Fog of War, we are going to do that, which, you know, makes it a little bit harder. And player morale is just a waste of time. Alright, so yeah, there we go. Superstar difficulty, which is the hardest one. That's what we run it on. Keep salary cap on. Gotta make it a challenge. Oh, so we're just gonna let this load up here. Yeah. Alright, here we are. We have nothing to do until the expansion draft, so that's what we're gonna do. Yep, expansion draft. Salary cap's gonna be 79.5 million. Draft pick wise, we ended up 5th, which is alright. This is the Svechnikov draft class. So we'll have a chance to maybe get him if we trade up, but I don't know what we're going to do yet. I want to see how our team turns out. And this is actually the first expansion draft that I've done. Our first, sorry, franchise mode I've really done in this game, to be honest. So that's a little bit of a challenge in itself, but I guess we'll begin here. Sorry about that. Alright, so yeah, we have, because this is, I guess, the season with Vegas or whatever, something like that. For whatever reason, Vegas isn't here, so we only choose from the 30 teams here, starting with Anaheim. We can go to any order. I think we have to take, it's like 14, at least 14 forwards, 8 defensemen, or sorry, 9 defensemen, 3 goalies. So yeah, let's do it. Yeah, starting with Anaheim, and they have a pretty solid team. You know, based off Ryan Miller and Barra, I'm not going to take any goaltenders from them. But looking at the skaters, you know, I don't want to take too many cap hits, and I only want to take really, you know, top forwards. You know, Manson's usually a pretty good go-to guy. Pretty solid player. And he actually, let me take a look at his stats and everything. Yeah, so 83 overall. Top four defenseman. He was actually a sixth round pick back in 2011. And he actually played in the BCHL before going to Northeastern NCAA Division I. And then he started playing for Anaheim. But yeah, he actually came out of Junior A, the Canadian system. And 26 years old, 83 overall, you know, first cap hits. That's a pretty good pickup, you know. We have Cogliano, Eves. I mean, I don't want Eves because of his age, Cogliano. Yeah, I just don't see it. You know, and all these guys here, I think the go-to guy is going to be Manson. That's just what makes sense. Arizona is going to be a little bit more of an interesting one. If I'm not mistaken, the goaltending's not really there either. Yeah, Darcy Kemper, which, you know, he's okay. You know, last season, Darcy Kemper, if I'm not mistaken, he played okay for a bad Arizona team. I mean, he had a .925 save percentage, which seems really good. But, you know, sometimes goalies have outstanding seasons. You know, you look at his other seasons, and he really struggled season prior with Arizona. He had an .899. These are things to take into consideration. But looking at this here, you know, I don't want to spend the money on Demers or Kruger. You know, we have Shen, we have Connaughton, and I think, based off these guys, you know, I think we're going to take Luke Shen. You know, he's an okay, maybe sixth defenseman. You know, he was a first-round pick, actually fifth overall by the Toronto Maple Leafs back in 2008. And he actually, at the beginning of his career, he played for, you know, Team Canada, the World Championships. But obviously, he hasn't been much of anything since. So, I think for this upcoming season, I think he's with the Tampa Bay Lightning. So, you know, we'll take him. But, you know, I think defensively, it's not necessarily a terrible pick since we are an expansion team in the expansion draft. Boston, we're not taking Khudobin. But looking at this Boston squad, you know, this is hard because, you know, we have Riley Nash, who's a pretty solid player. You know, that's actually a hard one. Yeah. Last season he played all right, had 41 points, 76 games played, signed with Columbus. This is last season with Boston, actually. And then, you know, Nick Holden's a pretty solid player. But, you know, I want to get some forwards in. You know, we've been going pretty D-heavy. But I think, honestly, we're going to go with Tommy Wingles, who actually signed with Genève Servette in Switzerland, I believe, for the upcoming season. And, you know, Wingles last season, you know, he actually played in Switzerland, having a point per game. But the season prior, you know, he's a good fourth-line guy. He's a pretty, you know, gritty kind of player. So, you know, 6 foot, 200 pounds roughly. So he's, it's hard. I think we're actually going to go with Nash, yeah. Oh, no, no, Nash. All right, Buffalo. I think goaltending, I want to wait for Grubauer. I think it's going to be our starter. Ooh, I mean, Ullmark. Hold on. Let me take a look at the skaters here. You know, Linus Ullmark, though, is a pretty solid pickup if we can get him. I mean, last season he had a, I think he had a 905 save percentage. This isn't right. This is his stats from something else, because he had a 905, I believe, with Buffalo. Oh, this is Chad Johnson. No wonder. Yeah, 922. That's his AHL stats with Rochester. But no, he had a 905 with Buffalo. 30-something games started. You know, that's pretty solid. But I think we're going to pass on him, because I want to wait for Grubauer as going Dill. But, you know, looking at the strong Buffalo squad, it's hard to make a pick, because we want to be cap-friendly. You know, Seth Griffith's pretty young. You know, solid third liner on an expansion team. Good playmaker. Really good playmaker back in juniors. If I'm not mistaken, Seth Griffith, he actually spent a lot of his junior career playing for London, I believe, the London Knights in the OHL, before getting drafted by the Bruins. You know, now he's obviously on the Sabres, but he was back on the Bruins a while back. Next up, though, we got the Calgary Flames. Yeah, I'm just checking goaltenders on each team just to make sure. That's true. First one. That's right. So, you know, we have... feel free, by the way, to put in, you know, put in your input on what you think. So, you know, we have Giordano, but the problem I don't like is he's 34 years old. He's got a contract that goes till 39, almost $7 million a year. You know, I think in this scenario, Lazar is the way to go. He's a good top six guy, only 23 years old, pretty cheap. And Curtis Lazar, I've always been a fan of his play. You know, right now he's, you know, a bit struggling, you know, playing the last season with Calgary. But I think in the right situation, he can grow to be, you know, a good top nine forward. Now we have the Hurricanes. Who do they have for goaltending? We're not taking the trash bag Scott Darling. Gosh, he's awful. Could barely even play for the Charlotte Checkers. Complete joke. But, you know, looking at this Hurricanes roster, I like Brock McGinn because of his age. But I think we're going to have to go with Carrick just because defensive. I mean, well, we have two D-men now. You know, and Martinook would be a good option. You know, Jordan Martinook, he's a 92, actually, and he played in the AJHL before going to the Vancouver Giants in the WHL. Spent a lot of time in the AHL, too, before he went to the NHL. And he was actually drafted by Phoenix. The Hurricanes later acquired him. And last season, he had, you know, 25 points. But, you know, it's hard. Do we want that offensive defense, or would we rather have that solid forward for us? You know, defensively, we're pretty strong. We have a pretty good, you know, top two right now, so we're going to go with Martinook. Chicago, I'm a big fan of Thomas Yurko. Love the way he plays. You know, he's played the last couple seasons in the World Championships, where I saw him play with the Slovakian national team first line. I thought he played, I think he plays outstanding. You know, last season he had almost a point per game with the Charlotte Checkers, actually. And I see no reason why he couldn't make an NHL roster. He's played over 200 NHL games for various organizations. I think Detroit and Anaheim, if I'm not mistaken. But, you know, out of the assets that were offered here on this, you know, weak, aging Blackhawks team, definitely taking Thomas Yurko. Colorado Avalanche. This is, yeah, we want Grubauer. You know, 26 years old, 83 overall. I'd say he's probably the best goaltender in this expansion draft, unless Lundqvist is in here, but he's pretty old, to be honest. And, you know, going into this season, I don't know what our exact goals are. You know, we can either tank and go for a really good draft pick, you know, or we can try to contend for a playoff spot, and I think we're going to try to contend for a playoff spot. You know, if we struggle, we struggle. And then we'll take Korpisalo as a backup. I like that. I like that goaltending duo right there. Two young goalies who, you know, have something to prove. Korpisalo being a Finnish goalie. Played a while with Team Finland. I think he was actually a backup for a little bit on the World Championships. Because Tuukka Rask was playing with Boston during that Stanley Cup run. Yes, I think we're pretty much set on goalies. Nothing really else major, but I think I'm looking through the roster. I think we're going to have to go with Steven Jones. I want to build on our decor a little bit. I don't want to blow a lot of money because, you know, we also have free agency. And that's where we can really, you know, maybe get some big names. I don't really know who's in the draft class. Yeah, the stream setup, it's decent. I like it. You know, I could see all the comments, so I don't have to look at a laptop or a phone or anything. It's not bad. It's not bad. I got to create a logo and everything for the channel, though. I haven't done that yet. But that's just going to take a little bit of time. Yeah, we're gonna take... I don't even know how to say that name, honestly. But I've seen him play a little bit with Detroit. Ule. I don't really know, to be honest. Edmonton, this is a team that... It's been struggling, obviously. And for them... I mean, I have an Xbox One, but I don't really play it much. To be honest. Yeah, it's just such a weak, you know, Eric Ribas, solid, big, you know, big, gritty defenseman. You know, may fill out our third D pair, but nothing much coming from it. Florida Panthers, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I knew we'd have Uyghur, Petrovic. Petrovic is a pretty good option. I don't have Chell on the Xbox. I'd have to buy it. And that's, I'm not going to waste $60 for, you know, but get it on Xbox. I don't ever play it on there, to be honest. Connor Brickley's alright, but, you know, I don't know, Petrovic or Uyghur. Petrovic is pretty big. I don't know how big Uyghur is. Ooh, this is hard. Oh, yeah, I forgot game shares. I think we have the same thing on PlayStation. It's called SharePlay. We're going to go with Uyghur because he's a bit younger. Los Angeles Kings. I like Alec Martinez. Tobias Ryder. I didn't realize he was German, but you know. We see what his shot abilities are. Yeah, he has a good slap shot. We'll take him. I want to get a little bit of scoring. I don't want to completely suck this first season. Looking at Minnesota. Another team with not the best selection options. But I think we're going to take Matt Colin. Yeah, he's a veteran. Maybe lead some of the younger guys on our team. And, okay, now Schlemko. I like Schlemko. I like Shaw. Is he worth that much money, though? Andrew Shaw. 20 points. I mean, Logan Shaw is... got a lot to prove. We're going to go with Logan Shaw. I want to save that cap. Nashville, powerhouse team right now. I don't think they have any goaltenders out there. Yeah, no one good. This is a team that we can make a good selection from. I don't know if we really need another defenseman that's top level. I'm a big fan, though, of Yarncroc. Great playmaker. Has a good shot, too. Great player overall, and you know, for 2 mil, 5 years, 26 years old, that's going to carry over in his prime. We're definitely going to take Yarncroc. New Jersey Devils, any goaltending here? Kincaid, 1.25, we'll take him. Islanders, pretty good team defensively, so you know, if we want another good defenseman, I think we'd be able to get it here. But yeah, Calvin DeHaan, nah, I'm not a fan of him. We have Thomas Hickey. Who, you know, he's alright. But, you know, as for Shane Prince, I'm more of a fan of Shane Prince here. You know, last season, he spent, you know, last season actually in the KHL. I think he had like 20 points, but he only played like 30 games due to injury. Good fourth liner. You know, no real cap hit there. Real cheap, so that's good. If you can see in the bottom left, you know, we have a little over 58 million cap space, so I really shouldn't be too worried about it. But, you know, whether it's this year or next year, we can get some good free. Jesper Fast, we're going to go with him. We're going to go with Jesper Fast. Pretty solid forward. Swedish, if I'm not mistaken. And actually, Jesper Fast, you know, last season, he had a decent season. I mean, he had 20 points in 66 games, which isn't good, but, you know, for an expansion team, what we're getting, it's pretty solid. He played, actually, in the Swedish Hockey League before coming over here for the club HV71. He had a pretty good season, you know, excelled in juniors, and also, you know, played pretty well, actually, in the SHL, which is a pretty good league. Next, we're up to... Oh, here we go. Alright, I think we're going to take McCormick here. Yeah. Philadelphia. I don't know everybody. You know, it just depends. I'm familiar with a decent amount of players, but definitely not all. But, you know, looking at Philly, I got to go with Jordan Veal. I love the guy. You know, love his playmaking abilities. And I remember he actually played a while in the AHL with Manchester before, you know, making his NHL debut. And since then, he's been kind of a fourth line forward. But, you know, he plays well defensively. And I think in the right situation, he'll be a good pickup for us. Pittsburgh. I wonder who we'll get from here. It'll automatically post itself after as a video. Yeah, we're definitely going to take Rude Weddle. San Jose. We already have our three goalies secured, so I'm not worried about that. I'm looking at our forward positions. We need two more D-men and some more forwards. And we have 53 million caps, so that's not a big deal. But age-wise, I like Goodrow. You know, Barclay Goodrow, I haven't seen too much of him, but I know he plays a pretty physical and gritty game for a forward. I think he got scratched actually a couple games, so it was a pretty solid third, fourth liner there for San Jose in this playoff run. All right, St. Louis. This is going to be a good one. Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, do they have... Maybe I want to switch goaltenders. Oh, they have Binnington. 73 overall, though. You know, this is the beginning of the season roster. So, the thing I'm scared about is... I don't think he'll reach the potential. But we're going to take him because, I mean, I can't pass up on that offer just in case. Let me get rid of Kincaid. We don't need four goalies. Instead of Kincaid, that's a tough decision. We're going to, yeah. Tampa Bay. I'm a Tampa Bay fan. So we definitely have to go with Tampa Bay. I'm not going to take Alex Korn. You know, that contract's going to run until he's 34 years old, $4.45 million. Can't do it. Andre Schuster, pretty good defenseman. Cedric Paquette, gritty defenseman. You know, Cedric Paquette, gritty defenseman, actually led the Lightning on faceoffs. I think he was like 60%. Not 60%, but 53%, which is, you know, pretty solid. Now we're going to Toronto. Toronto's, you know, based off their expansion draft selections, it's decent, but it's nothing, you know, too crazy. I'm a big fan of Josh Levo here. You know, he's only 25 years old, and he actually played a good while in the AHL. Oh, we got the boys to join. All right. He played split games last year with Toronto and Vancouver. You know, played a while with the Marlies in the AHL. Switched around in the OHL during his career. But the one thing I love about Josh Levo is, you know, back, especially in his junior days, great goal scorer, patient with the puck. I think he'll be a solid third liner for us. And, you know, don't forget to subscribe, guys. You know, we got to get that sub count up, you know what I'm saying? Good to see you, Billy. All right, looking at... we're going to take those. Ooh, no, Delzato has Biega. Yeah. PS4 is better than Xbox. I'd agree with you there. We got Washington here. We're going to take Connolly. Got to take him. And Vegas isn't a selection, so we're going to finish it off with Winnipeg. Six subs. That's a start. We're gonna go young with Lowry. And yeah, what the heck? We gotta have one more defenseman. Okay. Chiarot, yeah, Chiarot's definitely the guy to go. And Ben Chiarot signed with Montreal for the upcoming season. But he played a good while with the Wolf Storm in the OHL before he was actually traded to Sudbury. Started his career in the AHL. Actually, he started in the ECHL, if I'm not mistaken. Then went to the AHL. And now, you know, he's an alright player in the NHL. So, respect to him. Props to him. So we're going to finish our draft here. It's probably not one of my subs. I don't even know who those subs are, to be honest. This is my first video. Now we got the draft coming up. Can I assign my scouts? I can't. Okay, so we're going to simulate to the draft. Take a look at the draft board. Look at what prospects I want to, you know, target going into this draft. Just to get a better idea of what we're working with here. No, I don't want the draft board, sorry. View prospects, it should be. View draft class, there it is. Regular stream, I mean, heck, why not? You know, it's summer, why not? Yeah, I forgot, this is the Darlene, Svechnikov, Bakvis, Zadina draft. And we have the 5th overall pick. But I think we can maybe trade up. If we trade up, I don't want to go over for Darlene. I want to go with Svechnikov. Gotta go with Svech. You know, by the way, rip Svechnikov from the playoffs. Ovechkin absolutely murdered him. So, you know, rip Svech. But I think that's who we want to go with. Svechnikov had a pretty good rookie season this past season. And then I loved his play on the Barry Colts. Him and Ryan Suzuki now reunited on the Hurricanes. I loved their play on the Barry Colts, which is what made them such a good team in the OHL. All right, so Blackhawks got the first pick. I think they'll take Dowling, so let's take our chances and go for the second pick. Let's try and trade up. So obviously we're going to include our 5th overall pick. Yeah, that has a good amount of, you know, value. We're going to probably have a good draft next year. So let's go with 2021. We'll throw in a 2023 second rounder. So it might have value, but I think we'll be pretty solid by then. We won't have to worry about it. And then we'll throw in a player as well. We're going to go with... I like Curtis Lazar. Let's go with Riley Nash. I like that. And honestly, maybe I can get the 5th. The 7th. Get a couple of late round draft picks, maybe get a steal. Can we do that? No. Wait, what happened? Was it Riley Nash? Was that the problem? Okay, his contract expires, so you want a contract that's going to last a little bit. Okay. So you want a multi-year contract. Can I see contract length? I can. We'll give you Connolly. Yeah, we'll give you Connolly. Really? All right, let's take off these draft picks. Really? They want Lazar. They want Curtis Lazar. That's who I wanted to keep. Gosh dang it. Alright, we'll give it to you. Really? Alright, we'll add in another draft pick in the future, but I mean, come on, guys. I can't do more than that. We'll throw in our 2022 third. You gotta be kidding me. Okay, we'll throw in 2022 second. If that doesn't do it, then we're not gonna get it. Oh yeah, they definitely want Svech. But yeah, we're gonna go 2022 second. If this doesn't do it, I don't know what will. Gosh dang. I mean, come on, man. Alright, if I can hurry up, I can maybe get a trade with Chicago because they still haven't made their selection yet. Alright, I gotta hurry this up. Crap. Yeah, I didn't think so. Get rid of Lazar. Give him... Got 40 seconds. Manson. Dude, yeah, we're not going to get it. Oh, that sucks. Unless maybe, you know what, we're going to do it. We're going to give him another first. It hurts, but I'm gonna go all out for Svechnikov. I think he's going to be an integral part of our future. And we're going to do it. Oh, crap, we got 23 seconds. Crap. Really? You're telling me you won't take three first rounders, including this year's fifth overall, a second, and Madsen? Last thing I can do is give them a player that they want. Oh, that's already done. That's so stupid. Alright, let me get this trade with the Islanders here. Where the heck are the Islanders? Did I pass them? There they are. Okay. You know, now I'm including this first rounder. Okay, no, they won't do it. Alright. Curtis Lazar. Come on. Come on. Dude, you gotta be kidding me. I'll give you Madsen, that's it. And we're not getting Svechnikov. Oh gosh. Yeah, Rasmus Dahlin, send this pick. Svechnikov, gosh dang it. Who else is still on the board? I don't know who this is. I don't think it's a real player. But Andrei Alexeyev. And he seems interesting. I want to get a forward. I don't want to go with Filip Zadina. Yeah, maybe we can... Let's give him this year's first, and maybe another first, and we'll do that for this Russian guy, and that's it. Okay. Guys want Lazar. We'll give you those three pieces. Okay. This is getting to be ridiculous. That I can't make a trade. This is ridiculous. We'll give you next year's second rounder. If you don't take this, no deal. Okay. We're just going to have to suck it up and wait till the fifth pick. And I think we're going to get Zadina, worst case. There's the Russian. I'm going to be ticked off if the Sens take Zadina. Okay, we got Filip Zadina, which it could be worse. But we'll take him. I want a forward, so we'll take Filip Zadina. You know, he played last season in the AHL. Played all right, nothing too crazy. But, you know, he's all right. I think next year he's going to finally make the NHL roster. But, you know, his years in Halifax, one season in Halifax, he had like 80-something points in 50 games. So we'll draft Zadina. Now we'll make our way to the second round. Maybe get a steal or two. Got to look at what's on the board. 35th overall. Take a look at potential here. Ooh, franchise potential. Now, I didn't, because I'm the expansion team, I didn't have any scouts to scout these players. So that's a, this isn't even a real player, but that's a real iffy move. But, you know, he's slated to go in the second round. We're going to have to take him a bit early. Because I can't give up the chance of, you know, franchise potential. That doesn't come around every day. Third round. I'm surprised we haven't gotten any trade offers for any of our draft picks either. But in our third round, Kevin Ball. I'm actually a big fan of him. He plays pretty gritty, actually, for a defenseman. Pretty aggressive. I think he led the team actually last year in penalty minutes. But he's a pretty solid player. And I think he's actually going to play his another year juniors next year with Ottawa again. We don't have an AHL. I don't like the AHL top two potential, though, so that's why I'm not going to draft him. Xavier Bernard, yeah, we'll take him. You know, the main goal, you know, seven rounds, usually seven picks. You want to try to get two players that can make the NHL in the future. Usually your first rounder is typically a good player for that. And then, obviously, every once in a while, you got a couple later round guys that go on. Let's take a look here. Yeah, I like that top six potential, but it's low to hit it. And actually, this Jonathan Berggren guy, he actually played last year in the SHL. He struggled, but the season prior, he did pretty well in juniors. And the thing I like about him is I watched him play, at the World Juniors with the U18 squad, and I thought he played great. I think he had like 10 points, 5 games. It's pretty impressive. Got nothing on him, though. But I don't think it's really, we're missing anything, in the fourth round here by taking him. Fifth round, this is where it just starts getting iffy. I don't have any of these guys. Got Svenningsen. He also played, I believe, World Juniors. I think he was actually on the same line as Berggren. We'll take him. Alright, sixth round. We're getting close to the end here. Out of these guys, we'll take the one with potential, elite potential. But the one thing that sucks is none of these American players are licensed, these American prospects, that they won't even have Jack Hughes in next year's draft because EA doesn't have the USHL licensed, which is, it's a shame. Hold on a second. Extra Liga, yeah, is this the top guy from there now? Who do they have for the rest of the world? Anybody? Nah. I think back in 17, they used to have like some Chinese player, actually. I don't know if he was real or not, but they used to have him. We'll take Zach Malik, though. He actually did play for Sudbury, the Wolves, this past season. Pretty solid defenseman. I don't think he'll, at best, I think he'll be, an okay AHL-level player. Nothing special. But that's our draft. I thought it went okay. I was hoping to get Svechnikov, which obviously didn't happen. But now we go to the contract phase, getting closer to the start of the season. Yeah, I already know all that stuff. Restricted free agents, unrestricted. So let's just get in here. Yeah, all expiring. Let's start with our centers. All right, how much does Riley Nash want? This is going to be interesting. Yeah, I mean, if you'll sign for that much, we'll give it to you. Cedric Paquette. Yeah, I'll give that to you, too. 24 years old. Good. Gritty. I think he actually was one of the forwards with, some of the most hits in the league for any forward this past season. Matt Cullen will bring you back. Yeah, veteran. Brings a little bit of experience. Good third-line center. Fourth line. Yeah, Tobias, we want you. We'll give you a little bit more so you sign for sure. Shane Prince. Another guy who I think in the right system can blossom. How much cap do we have? We have 53 million cap, so I'm not worried about it at all. Once free agency hits, I think we'll be able to get, a couple high-quality guys. Again, I love Thomas Yurko and how he plays, especially with Team Slovakia. Played great last year at the World Championships. Yeah, but we could sign these guys. Yeah, we want Logan Shaw. Yep. Defenseman. Only have two contracts here to renew. So we're going to have a lot of money to spend in free agency, which is good. I don't really know if there's any big names, though, in this year's class. Binnington. Still don't know if he's going to hit his potential, but I'm giving him the opportunity. Because he's only 73 overall in this game. And then we'll go to our draft picks and, let's sign them all. Philip Zadina. Yeah, was this what? Oliver Wharton, I think it was. Owen, excuse me. That was that American player. This was Berggren's teammate on Team Sweden. Sign these guys. I don't know why we're giving them all 925 yachts. I mean, he could take 825. But even, you know, 25,000, you know, could matter at the end of the day. Alright, we should be good. I know we're not going to have any issues with roster spots, you know, because we have plenty of room in our roster. Okay, accepted. Nice. I don't really care if they really Matt Cullen decline. Wants to go ring chase. Alright. Really? Logan Shaw, what a scumbag. Okay. Is anybody else? Let's go to free agency. So, based off the roster, you know, what are you guys thinking? What are you guys thinking? I'm thinking, you know, I don't think we're going to make playoffs, but I think we should try to push for a wild card. Free agency. Here we go. Joe Thornton. He's old, and that's why. It's iffy. But, even though he's old, you know, we have it's one season, we have tons of cap, so we'll give him an offer that he can't deny. 6.3 mil. No way he declines that. Ooh, yeah. I'm not going to sign you to a 5-year deal, I can't do that. Brian Rust can't do that either. Stastny? 4 years, we can do that. We can make that happen, yeah. Andre Schuster. We'll try to sign you too. He's a solid second D pair. Bozak? Yeah. We want Tyler Bozak. And then... if we can get... oh, yeah, Trevor Van Riemsdyk. I feel like it's a bit expensive for him, but, you know, we'll go for it. Any goalies on here that are top quality? Bernier, he's alright, but not what I'm looking for. Right, I'm waiting to see when they respond, what day it's going to be. Come on. Wow. Alright, Stastny accepted, Van Riemsdyk, Thornton, yep, Schuster, Bozak. So everybody accepted. So we can go. Send them to the regular season. Once we get there, you know, I'll assemble our team. We got a trade offer here. Take a look here. Okay, so we have... what is that? Andreas Martinsson, I believe. He's actually a Norwegian player. Played last year in the AHL mostly. And he struggled. But he played in the World Championships for Norway. You know... not a guy that I'm really a fan of. Let me see what his stats are, if anything. Yeah, I mean, he's not terrible, but I don't think we need forwards of that. You know, I don't think we need, you know, really third, fourth liners. What we need is top end guys. Okay, I see what they're doing here. So they're pretty much giving us a fourth round pick, but the thing is, we gotta take Hansel's. That's gonna suck. We'll have to take his contract, and I don't know if it's really worth it. Martin Hansel, he's making a lot of money. I think last season he only had like 10 points, and he only played like 30 something games. So, yeah, no can do. McKenzie, he's, I think, if I'm not mistaken, that's Derek McKenzie, who, he's pretty old, if I'm not mistaken. You know, not a guy that's going to help us again. Not a guy that's going to help us. Excuse me. So let's just keep Simeon to free agency. You know, while we're waiting on it, let's talk about Hughes and Kako. Who's going to be better? Jack Hughes is going to be initially better, I think. But I think Kapokako is... I think he's going to also struggle. I think he's going to struggle at first. But I think, you know, a little bit into, you know, a couple games, a couple seasons of the league, he's going to truly blossom. I don't know how long this is going to take either. But what we ought to do is we gotta... Oh, there we go. Edit lines. Perfect timing. Okay, so... Yeah, well, yeah, let's turn this on just because of injuries and whatnot. I like our forward core of, you know, Joe Thornton, Paul Stastny, and the type of Bosak, Riley Nash. I like that. Left wingers, we got, yeah, Yaron Kroc, Tobias Ryder, Martinook, Paquette, Lazar, Connolly, Nosen, Jesper Fast. I like this. I think this is a good forward core here. It's going to do some good. Andre Schuster, Manson, Riemsdyk, Johns, Ule, Ruhwedel. Yeah, that's awesome. Who do we have scratched? Okay. And if I'm not mistaken... Okay, that's fine, that's fine. AHL team. Yeah, Barclay Goodrow, Jordan Wheel, Thomas Yurko, Griffith. That's our... I guess we picked him up at free agency or something that I didn't know about. These two guys, Jacob Nelson, Antti Suomela, Shane Prince, Levo. Yeah, we drafted him in the expansion draft. Tulola, Cormac. Where's Zadina? Okay, I don't even know where he is. Not a big deal, though. And, yeah, I'm going to be honest. I don't really care about preseason. We're just going to go the regular season. Because in this game, preseason doesn't mean anything. Excuse me. Oh, man. Excuse me. Just doesn't. Alright, so I think... I actually have no clue who we opened the season up against. Yeah, well, we'll definitely be in compliance with the salary cap. Waivers start in October. Yeah, that's October 11th. Assign our scouts. Yes. You know, pro scouts, I usually let them do their thing on their own. The ones that I like to watch is... Our junior or amateur scouts. I usually like to set one in a certain location for the entire season. That way I have a pretty good scope of all the prospects and, you know, what's expected of them throughout the entire season. DEL, what do we have here? Alright, how are you this bad? Yeah, just get fired. Yeah, you're completely worthless if your rating's a D-. You're completely worthless. But DEL... Definitely a guy that we can use. SHL is important too, and the Liga. These are all important scouts. The last European one I really want to get is a, besides Russia, is the Czech Extraliga. That's going to be another location that I want to, you know, have an idea of what's going on there, too. Right, higher. There we go. Higher scouts. Just a European scout. C overall. Yeah, we'll sign ya. That's the last one that I really want. Is that one we can assign him and sign his contract? He did. Okay, let me assign Scout. Let me assign him. Where is he? Okay. Is he extra legal? Let me just make sure. Okay, that's interesting. But his regional accuracy is at A+. Okay. Or then yeah, we'll just have him scout the entire season as well. Go for it. Get us some good news. And you know, I think that's gonna be it for this first episode. If we're just us setting up our team, getting everything working. You know, this is our final roster to start the season, which I'm a fan of. I still don't know where the heck Zadina is. Maybe he's playing another year of juniors, I don't know. But yeah, I like it. Like it a lot. Let me make sure we have him signed. Yeah, in the system. Wait, where is he? Can I assign him somewhere? So he is on an AHL team. Did I miss it? I don't see him here at all. I have no clue. I'm sure he'll be with us soon. He might be playing juniors like I said earlier. But yeah, this is it. Starting our season off against the Golden Knights. You know, I think I'm going to play the first game and then simulate all the rest just because I do want to get a feel for the team at least once. And yeah, okay. You know, for an expansion team, I don't think we have too bad of a team. Actually, we'll save this for episode 2. We'll do that, yeah. Sorry to leave you on that cliffhanger, but yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one.